every match. These four three is for every match. Nothing depression will be there. That's why the value of S3 is equal to 0. Now come to the another property. From the property of the Euclidean tree, you can see that this from root number 1 to 3, this is S13 and this is S23. So both are equal in magnitude but opposite in phase. So that's why I have written S13. S13 is equal to minus of S23 because it is equal in magnitude but opposite in phase. That's why we have mentioned these things. Now come from the unitary property. From the unitary property, you can see that the S matrix and their complex conjugate is equal to unitary. So here, what you mean by the unitary? That means it is a diagonal matrix where if it is a 3 × 3, it is a 3 × 3, then it is also 3 × 3. So here it will be 1 1 0 0 1 0 and 0 0 1. So this is a diagonal matrix that is called I. And so now here from the symmetry property, you know that from the symmetry property we can write that Sij is equal to Sji, means rho. Now S, if I is a 1 and J is equal to 2, then J is equal to S21. Like suppose S12 is equal to S21 based on this symmetric property, because here I is equal to 1, J is equal to 2, and then equal to J become I and I become J, so S21. Like that, from this property we can say that we can write S12 is equal to S21, S23 is equal to S32, S13 is equal to S minus S13. So now we, what is the property, what is the matrix we form after applying all this property? This particular matrix become S11, S12, S13, nothing change. Now it is S21. This is your S21, but we know that S21 is equal to S12. So we have replaced this S21 is equal to S12. Now S22, S22, we have kept common. Now we know that S23, this S23 is equal to minus of S13, minus of S13. This S31, this S31, we can write S31 is equal to S1 from symmetric property S13. This become S32. S32 is equal to S23, and S23 is equal to S31. So minus of S31, we can write S matrix. This is the computed. This is the after applying the property of S matrix. So now we apply this property, property of inheritance. So this is S matrix. Then we have to write complex conjugate. So we give complex conjugate, same rights, same things, and multiply with the complex conjugate. We just make the complex conjugate same things. Same things is that only we have added complex conjugate is equal to this, and this complex is equal to unitary 1 0 0 0 0 1 1 1. So now what we will do, we have for the calculations or finding the value of all parameters, we have selected this is the row 1, row 2, row 3, this is column 1, column 2, column 3. Now here we have to do some mathematical equations, like we have to multiply with the row 1 with the column 1. So row 1 with the column 1 we can do, row 1 is equal to S11, if both we multiply it becomes square. If this we multiply, this multiply with this, it becomes square. If this multiply with this, it becomes square. N is equal to 1. This is the position 1. So it's equal to first. Now then part. This row is multiply with this. Then you will get this expression. This row is going to be multiplied with the column 3. Then it becomes this equation. So from equations 1 and 2, you can see that. If you do the minus, this same, and you can see this same, only these and these are different. So here you can see that this value S11 is equal to S22. So now here this is S11 is equal to S12. Now here you can see that, and now from the equation number 3 you can see that if you solve this value S13 plus S13 per whole square, then one, then if you solve these, it will you can receive the value of S13 is equal to 1/2, and then it becomes 1/2. So from equation you will get the value of S13 is equal to 1/2. multiplication. This row R3 is going to be multiplied with the C1 column, this column C1. Now that this become S13, this become interesting minus S13 minus this. So here you can take common S13 and this one. So overall, if this equal to 0 or this equal to 0, so if you put this equal to 0, then S11 complex conjugate become S12, or you can write S11 is equal to S12. So this equations come here. Now we have to put this value into expression number 1, or equation number 1. Once we substitute this value into equation number 1, this becomes S11 square. Instead of S12, we are putting S11. S1 square plus S13 square. We know the value of S13 square. This is value of 1 by root 2 square. So 1 by root 2. 1 minus 1 by root 2, 1 by 2. This is two types of S11 square. So now overall, if you calculate S11, finally you will get the value of S11 is equal to 1 by 2. If you keep the value, this becomes two types of S11 power square, and this become 1 minus this value. This become this value. So this become overall S11 is equal to 1 by 2. If you substitute the value of S11 here, final matrix is what? Final matrix is this one. So here S11 is 1 by 2. This is also because S11 is equal to S12, this is also 1 by 2. S13 is equal to 1 by root 2. S12 is equal to 1 by 2. S22 is equal to S22. Yeah, sorry, this is your S22. This S22 is become, this S22 becomes S11. So then it becomes 1 by 2. Right? And here, this is S13, this becomes 1 minus root 2. This becomes 1 by root 2. This becomes minus 1 by root 2 and 0. So finally, you are getting expression 1 by 2, 1 by 2, 1 by root 2. Here you can see that all the quadrants are 1 by root 2, 1 by root 2. Plus minus, you just remember. And this is because of the matching property, this becomes 0. So 1 by root 2 minus 1 by root 2 is 0. 1 by root 2 minus 1 by root 2 is 0. Like you can think like that. If you add 1 by root 2 minus 1 by root 2 is 0. 1 by root 2 minus 1 by root 2 is 0. Then all these numbers are 1 by 2, 1 by 2, 1 by 2 like that. If you remember all the these parameters are 1 by 2, 1 by 2. Side terms are 1 by root 2, 1 minus root 2. And like this, it is coming from the expressions. So now, based on this, you can conclude that based on this expression, based on these expressions, here I am going to be explain the property of S matrix. So now let us assume here. Here you can see that we have received this value. Let us take, this is my port B is my output, and it is written in terms of inputs. So this is my output port and this is my input port. Let us say B1, B2, B3, this is my output port, and here the matrix which is having a 1 by 2, 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 minus, and this is 1 by 2, 1 square root, this is 1 by 2, and 0. So now this become A1, A2, A3, right? You can write this expression into like this. Or you can write B1 port is equal to A1 by 2, plus A2 by 2, plus A3 by root 2. B2 port is equal to, you can give A1 is by plus A2 by 2, plus minus of A3 by root 2. And here you can see that port B3 is equal to, you can write right now here the value A1 by root 2 and minus of A2 by root 2. And this becomes zero. Now here you can see that from this expression you can see now what are the conclusions we have to draw, right? Here you can see that case first, if A3 is not equal to 0 and A1 and A2 both are 0, means we are applying certain input into the port 3 and we are not applying any input to here, we are applying the input to port number 3. Then what happening? Please put all these values. Then B1 become A3 by root 2 and B2 port become minus of A3 by root 2 and this B3 become 0. So here you can see that whenever you are applying the input into port number 3, right? what number theorem applies under certain inputs, then you can see that this input is divided equally. This side a3 by root 2 and this side a3 by root 2, but it is opposite this. At b2 is how much? This is minus and this is b1. This is b2 port, this is b1 port. So equally it is divided. Equally it is divided in terms of magnitude, but opposite in phase. So this property, we know that whenever we are giving electric field into the input number 3, this power is equally divided and phase are opposite. So this particular matrix is giving or verifying the property of your matrix. Now this is case first. Case second. Right? You give a1, a2, right, is equal to a, and nothing you will give to a3. If you will not give anything into the port number 3, but you are giving input port a1 and a2 which is equal to a, all are common. Right? Means here we are giving input, here we are giving input, but we are not giving here any input. So what should be the output response at port 1, port 2, port 3? Right? So here you can see that what it becomes, here it becomes C. V1 is how much? It becomes A by 2 plus A by 2. Right? And A3 is equal to 0. How much it is? A. Now it becomes 2A by A. 2 by A by 2. So A. B2 is equal to how much? B2 is of how much? A by 2. This is 0. A by 2. This is 2A by 2. This is A. Now what about B3? It becomes A by root 2 minus A by root 2. 0. So means if you are applying equal magnitude into port number 1 and port number 2, apply port number 1, port number 2 equal magnitude, here the thing will come at port number 3, because this will cancel. Because both it will shift and it will be cancelled. Because if you enter equal magnitude, but phase will be changed, and once it is entered into the electric field, it will be 0. So here you can see that port number 3, we will not get anything. But if you will apply from port number 3 any inputs, it is equally divided and opposite in the phase. So this is the overall concept of if and this. So hope you guys are understood. Thank you.